Hey, Fragrance Family, I'm Daver.
And I'm Carlos.
And we're the Fragrance Bros.
What's up, what's up?
Coming at you again with another review with Carlos. How are you doing, Carlos?
I'm good, and you?
Doing great. Glad to have you on again. And we are reviewing Dior Homme Sport 2012 by Dior, of course. Date introduced is 2012. Now, this is the new version. They had an older version that came out a few years prior. It's classified as a woody aromatic. Notes are citron, iris, ginger, and cedar. Now, Carlos, what do you get out of longevity out of this?
This is one of those short-lived beauties for me. A couple of hours.
Yeah, I would say on me, I think it was probably a little bit longer, but it was pretty weak. It was probably, barely on the 6 hour range for me, but probably a little bit less than that.
But that's long for what I got out of it. But I sprayed it pretty liberally, and a couple of hours is really all that I got from it.
Now, what about projection? What did you get out of projection out of this?
No projection. After the fizzy, gingery, very clean opening, it mutes right away on my skin. On my skin. And it's nice enough, in my opinion, but it goes flat real fast.
Yeah, on me, it was pretty poor, too. This is pretty much a skin scent almost the entire time that you have it. And I don't know if they meant to do that on purpose, like if they meant to make a sporty fragrance that, you know, when your body is warm already, it'll radiate the scent on its own. So I don't know if they meant to make it to where you're supposed to have a light fragrance and maybe your body just radiates the scent. But most people aren't going to wear this when they're, you know, working out.
No. I still don't get that wearing fragrance while you're working out thing. And I'm a diehard perfumista or fume head, whatever you want to call it. I don't really work out.
Season, I would say this is best for spring and summer and daytime. And purpose, I would say this is, you know, really what you get is just great for casual and maybe work.
Yeah, I mean, it's so inoffensive. You can't smell it. It's so inoffensive. It's...
That's right. It doesn't offend anybody because it doesn't say anything.
It won't offend you. It won't offend nobody.
So what does this fragrance remind you of?
It reminds me of post-shower clean, and that's about it. It's a little gingery and citrusy in the beginning, and then it's clean. It's kind of boring, if you ask me. And I've heard so much about the previous one. I mean, I see people all the time raving about Dior Homme, the original, the pre-formulation. I've never smelled that one. Have you?
Yes, I have actually smelled the original one. I thought the original one was kind of boring as well. So it still has a ginger and it still has like the lemon in the opening, both of that. But it's a little bit different. And in some ways, I kind of actually do like the old version better. But maybe only slightly, because I didn't love the original version. I thought the original version it didn't really blow me away. And to me, this version is probably a little bit more sporty than that version. Mm-hmm. But I don't know if that's a better thing.
Well, I could see putting this on post gym or even if you must wear fragrance to work out, this would definitely work because it's so quiet. And so short-lived.
Yeah. I will actually say that, like, the old version is stronger. It's pretty much, you know, standard fragrance, what you would expect.
Yeah.
This one is really, really kind of subdued compared to that one. But as far as this scent, what I get is exactly what you're saying. Like, it is just this fizzy ginger lemon scent at the opening, and it does kind of get flat over time. There's almost like a slight metallic note in there somewhere, but maybe that is the part that kind of smells a little bit flat to me.
It's just how quick that it goes flat. Like if the opening and that gingery fizzy thing lasted, you know, a couple hours, it would be decent for what it is. Yeah. But it just goes so quick. It's very synthetic smelling.
Yeah, I can see that too. This is different in that the reformulation of this has iris in it, and the original one didn't have iris in it. And the iris kind of adds like this this sweet quality about it almost.
I didn't get really much iris out of it. You know, thinking back on Dior Homme, there's iris there. I didn't get iris in this one.
I think the iris that they use in this is kind of a different variety than they use in like Dior Homme. Because that one, I think they use kind of like the iris butter type smell. And this one, I think they use more of like the flower, which is a little bit, it was a little bit different. I don't actually like that as much. Yeah, it is very in the background. And it's very different than what you would think connected to Dior Homme.
Right.
Now, I almost smell aldehydes in this, and I don't know if it's in there or not, but maybe that's what the citrusy note in there is, and maybe that's metallic note in there. Not that it's important, but it does kind of have a almost aldehydic type smell in this. This fragrance won't win any awards at all, but I do think that if you wear this, I think people will probably like it if they can smell it at all. People have to get up close to you to smell it, that's for sure.
It's a skin scent. It's a skin scent, a boring flat skin scent. I sprayed this on probably about an hour ago, and it was real bright and nice and gingery. And this is like, it's nothing. I put on a fair amount. You know, I pretty much used up the sample here. No bueno, Mr. Frag Bros. No me gusta.
I don't hate this fragrance. I think it's pleasant, but it just doesn't really do anything for me. And it almost seems like there's something missing in this fragrance. And that's the one thing that I think really bothers me is when you see this compared to in the Dior Homme line, you're going to think that it should be something more than it is. And I don't know. It just fell flat.
There should be more of a connection creatively and, even if it was the iris or whatever, it's a flanker. It's way different than the other two.
Now, what about compliments? Did you get any compliments while wearing this?
I honestly didn't wear it out, so I can't say that I did or didn't get compliments, but seeing how this wore on me, there would be no compliments. there wouldn't be any. Unless somebody was standing in my immediate area when I initially sprayed it, then possibly they'll be like, it smells good. But
my wife liked it, but she didn't love it. And I think that's what it's going to be for a lot of people out there when you wear this. If they can smell it at all, and they're right on your skin and they're smelling it, they're probably going to think it's nice. But they're not going to be blown away by it. And overall, I think that's the impression that I get from this fragrance. I think most people are going to get from this fragrance. It's nice. It's okay. You know, it's not bad.
This is an expensive hobby, and nice doesn't cut it anymore for me.
That's right.
I don't know you, but there are much more better, nice choices than this one.
Yeah, absolutely. Absolutely. I'm thinking of, you know, a lot from Imaginary Authors line. They have a whole bunch of fresh, citrusy fragrance that blow this out of the water. Now, bang for buck, this is $75 for a 3.4 ounce. And overall, I think that's a decent value, but I mean, you just really have to really love this fragrance to spend the money, I think.
And you're going to go through it real quick if you do decide to buy a bottle, because you're going to have to respritz, like, very frequently.
Now, final rating, what do you give this fragrance, Carlos?
I'll give this a 2, just for the opening.
Yeah, I think I'm going to give this a 3. I don't hate this fragrance. It does seem like there's a little something missing. It doesn't really, to me, fit with the Dior Homme line. It's not amazing at all, but it's nice. I think it's just not my thing.
You're a little more fair than me. and I think I'm a fair guy.
You are a fair guy. So that's all we got. Let us know down in the comments down below whether you like Dior Homme Sport 2012 or not. Let us know. And of course, like and subscribe if you haven't already. And thanks again, Carlos, for coming on. It's been a pleasure having you on as a guest again.
Thank you. My pleasure.
So that's all we got. I'm Dave.
I'm Carlos.
And we're the Fragrance Bros. See you later.
Ciao.
Bye.